We're out here in deeper water trying to find where these fish are gonna relate to. You know, we're looking right now, this is the Lowrance Carbon HDS-12, and we're looking at an isolated log pile out here on the left. And you know, when I see something like this, it's real easy for me to mark it. And I wanna identify areas of change. So the nice thing on the Lowrance, I can scroll back and I can look, there's actually two piles here, and I can zoom in on those piles. I can see there, I mean, you can look at it. There goes a branch, there's a branch. And I could hit that, put my cursor on top of it, drop a waypoint, and now I've got that piece of cover on my graph. You know, one of the key things anytime you're fishing offshore is I'm trying to take information and then I'm trying to process it to figure out where the fish are gonna be. So I'm looking at 2D, I'm looking at side imaging, I'm looking at water temperature, and I'm looking at my mapping cards, and I'm trying to put it all together. You know, again, the main factor that I'm always looking for when I'm fishing offshore is areas of change. Fish hardly ever relate to static areas, but they like areas of change. So we marked a log, and I'm moving along this point, and I know there's another big log. Here it comes on the side imaging. A giant log laying on the side, right on that break. Here's another area, put my cursor on it, put a waypoint, and now I've got that log. The other thing I like to do is I color coordinate my waypoints. So for the logs, I'm going to use a blue X, but if I find grass, I'm going to use a green money sign. So it visually gives me a clue as I'm idling and looking. Here it goes, look at this. Great, another type of cover, and now we've got a grass edge. And once again, on 2D, you can see it as towering grass. If we go over to structure scan and zoom in, it looks like grass. Grass shows up as grass on the screen. It's a great example of what we're looking for. You know, once again, you can see this edge. And edges are another key word for me when I'm out here side imaging and looking offshore. So I'm gonna go back, and a lot of times I use what's called a zigzag pattern. And I'm gonna go in and out, and I'm gonna ride those contours looking for areas of change. Once again, I can do it on 2D. I can mark that hard edge of vegetation. This time it's grass, so I'm gonna change my waypoint icon. I'm gonna use a green money symbol. I'm gonna save it. And now if we look on our map, here we go. A primary cove, secondary point coming out of a spawning pocket. We've got two giant log piles marked, and we've got an edge of grass marked. You know, electronics are so important, but I don't want you guys to get overwhelmed by the price of these things. You know, I'm a Lowrance sponsored guy. I'm running these high-end units, but all these companies offer entry-level models, and they do an excellent job. Remember, what you're looking for with these things is areas of change, where the bottom drops, where the bottom rises, pieces of cover. And even on entry-level electronics, you're gonna find those areas of change. The best way to learn this stuff is during a fun fishing trip, practice day way ahead of an event. Go out and learn these things. Launch on a lake that you know and side image physical pieces of cover that you can see on the bank. A bridge piling, docks, standing timber, and then compare that to what you see on 2D and structure scan. Now you have an image with your eyes, and you also know what it looks like on your underwater eyes. Let me tell you, gain confidence in these things, and you're gonna find fish that the average guy doesn't find.